Karma is like a concept for Maya. This is my name. I would like you to talk about karma and how do you see it as a concept?
You are believing that karma is just one concept. Really, if we pour seed, we'll get fruit. But immediately we are getting fruit, or it will take time for fruit? No, we pour seed of mango, at least 5 years we will get, after 5 years we will get fruit. So, due to ignorance, we don't know who am I, and we are believing that I am, say, whatever name given to the body, say Deepak. So if I believe I am Deepak, then I am doing some action. Due to wrong belief, I am doing some action. Oh, this is correct, this is wrong, this is right, this is good, this is bad, this should not do, this should do. So like that, that action of ego, ego means due to wrong belief, ego gets generated. And ego, action of ego means karma. Whatever belief of ego is karma, and it is seed for this life. And fruit will come in next life. We eat, we cannot get immediately discharged. It will take 24 hours to come out. So like whatever we pour seed, it is this life. And action or causes in this life, effect will come in next life. Like that causes and effect, effect and causes of karma cycle starts. And your question, that very first beginning, from where this all starts. Really, in this world, there are 6 eternal elements. One is pure soul, one is matter, one is space, one is time, another 2 elements to supporting motion and demotion. So there are 6 eternal elements. And when the element comes in rotation, so in it, when it comes near each other, phases of the element gets generated. Just like moon, earth and sun, they are revolving each other. And phases of the moon starts. You can see 4th day of moon, 5th day of moon, full moon, dark, full darkness. So these are the phases of moon. But moon is not destroyed, or it is not become less or more, it remains constant. But phases of the moon can be changed. We can see phases of the moon. We cannot understand what is absolutely moon is, but we can see phases of the moon. So like that, soul or matter, we cannot see as element, absolute element, but we can see phases of the element. And due to wrong belief that I am Maya or I am Deepak, so that wrong belief is action. Otherwise, that phases automatically gets generated due to revolving each other, all elements. And that action, due to ignorance, action we are doing. And once you do action, automatically reaction will come. And reaction, so action is a karma. And reaction is a fruit of karma, a result of karma. So, by ignorance, we are charging karma and we are getting result of karma as a discharge. Like whole cycle starts. Once you realize yourself, who am I, then action will stop. So, charging of karma can be stopped by realization of self, who is the doer, who am I. And then you are stopping your charging new karma. And when we stop our charging new karma, still we have to finish our discharge karma, because we have made action in past, or we have poor seed in past life. So in this life we have to suffer discharge karma. But awareness of pure soul and who is the doer, if we keep that awareness, automatically new charging of karma will stop. And that stoppage, automatically next new result of karma will not come, and that is called liberation, that is called ultimate salvation. You understood?
Yes. Could you also say it's cause and effect or duality? Can you compare it with it from your point of view?
Cause and effect kevaye ke ene dvait kevaye, duality.
No, it is cause and effect.
Yeah.
Duality is different thing.
But karma is cause and effect, you would
say.
Yeah,
karma is cause, and result of karma is effect.
Effect, yeah. Okay, thank you very much.